the main topic of my paper is Antonio Gramsci. Antonio Gramsci was maybe the most important Marxist intellectual and politician in Italy in the last century. And the main topic of my paper is the problem of a Jewish question in Gramsci's writings, and mostly in Antonio Gramsci's correspondence with his sister-in-law Tatiana, and we'll try to check whether Gramsci's position on a Jewish question has developed some original answer to the national territorial problem. Well, my paper has been divided in four parts. The first part deal with the general Jewish question in the Second International period, from the end of 19th century until the First World War. In the second part addressed the problem of the language in Gramscian works in the light of the recent works on the Soviet period of Gramsci. And the third part of my paper will deal with the Gramscian treatment of the Jewish question and Zionism, and the discussion in correspondence with Tatiana. Then the fourth part will deal with the problem of the state in Gramscian works. And finally, we try to check whether a Gramscian position contains some innovative check about the Jewish national question or about the Jewish minority and non-territorial problem. Well, the first part, yes, these are the main questions of my paper. Can we see in Gramscian position something new about the non-territorial autonomy, or was Gramsci an epigon of the most important theoretician of the Second International? Another main question is, did the Gramscian works discuss the Jewish national question or not? And the last is, can we propose a Zionist interpretation of Gramscian historicism regarding to language, ethnicity, and the socialist society? Well, I'm starting with the Young Marx, because Gramsci translated some parts of Marx's Jewish question and during the prison period, and I think it's important how Gramsci tried to go back to the sources of the so-called most important source of his Marxian thinking in order to answer to his sister-in-law's objection about Jewish identity. Well, this is the well-known interpretation of Marx in his in article in 1843. About the Second International debate on Jewish national question, we have just spoken about Renner and Bauer, about the main thesis of Renner, you know, languages manifest element of individual belonging to a national group and extraterritorial corporation. 8 years after the most important Renner's writing on Jewish national question, we have Otto Bauer and his position is a personalist principle, which was, we know, very, very important for Bundist elaboration of alternative vision of the social democracy in a Russian context. Yes, we have the Leninist position was showed mostly by Stalin in 1913 in his writing on of national question, and this is the problem. Most important problem about Stalin's writings was whether Jewish identity as or should be considered as a national or cultural independent part or entity, and this we know that Stalin did not agree with Bund, and as Lenin as well. Lenin wrote something about the national question during his period in 1913 in Switzerland, and this is most important to say. How can we distinguish between nations that have the right to territorial self-determination the nations that have not this right? This is the most important question which Stalin tried to answer in this booklet of 1913. Yes, Karkowski is another position. I think is important position because Karkowski has a middle position between Austro-Marxism and Leninism, since can we see that Karkowski support Bundist autonomous politics in Russian context, and you can say that Karkowski was Bundist in his view of Jewish national question, was Bundist and anti-Zionist because according to Karkowski, the so-called Palestinian territorialism of Zionism was against history, and therefore it was not to be considered as an answer to the Jewish so-called Jewish question. Yes, now about the so-called Marxist Jewish position, we have two most important Marxist Jewish position. The first one is Bunde. We have just spoken with Ronnie about Medem's book, article of, about the social democracy and the question, Jewish national question. Yes, this most important thing the problem of neutralism, so-called neutralism, since you know Medem was neither for nor against assimilation, because the main task of Bund was again for Medem to prepare a long-term Jewish assimilation without forcing it. Yes, this is more important to say. The second most important position was the position of Marxist Borokhov. Borokhov was one of the most original thinkers in Marxian Russia, according to me. And he has an important interpretation of Zionist autonomy, but also I think a Marxist, so-called Marxist interpretation of anti-Semitism and class consciousness. And according to Borokhov, Palestinian solution was the most fitted for Jewish working class and for the advent of a socialist society. But another important question in Borokhov writings was the so-called Yiddish language problem. And for Borokhov, Yiddish language was the true historical tongue of the Jewish working class. And we say the different from position from Medem. From Medem, Yiddish was instrumental, not something eradicated in Jewish history. This is the most important. And then we see when we start with the Gramscian position. Well, now, the problem of Gramsci and the tongue. The tongue is one of the most important problems, according to me, in Gramscian works, which is the importance of the language for the creation of a new society or of a new socialist society. And we can see in Gramsci three most important authors, three most important characters, which can we see influenced his view. The first one was maybe the most important Italian glottologist in the 19th century, Grazia Dio Isaiah Ascoli, was of Jewish origins. Grazia Dio Isaiah Ascoli elaborated a theory against the centralist position of Alessandro Manzoni, who was the most important literary figure in Italian Risorgimental period. And grazie a Dio, Isaiah Ascoli, most important theory are the theory of substratum, which is a sort of bottom-up model of cultural hegemony, which is coming from civil society, not from the state. And Gramsci, in his prison quaderno number 29, elaborated Ascoli's position about languages, and according to Gramsci and in accordance with Ascoli, language play a very important role for the development of class consciousness of working class and the occupation, the future occupation, the socialist society, the new state. The second important character for Gramsci was Matteo Bartoli. He was a Dalmatian, Austro-Hungarian expert of dialectology, and is most important since Gramsci studied with Bartoli at the University of Torino before the First World War. And most important concept in Bartoli, according to me, is the concept of a radiation center, which is to Gramsci the starting point for the thesis of home focolare, which Gramsci using in the quaderno number 29. And this concept of radiation center, we see, is not so different from Hakatam spiritual center. This is very important to say. And for Gramsci, the concept of radiation center will be very important in elaboration of the concept of prestige and hegemony, which are the main important Gramscian concept. The third character which influenced Gramsci was Lenin. Lenin was, you know, against Bund, and he was from a dialectical materialist position against, yes, the personalistic Kantian principles of also Marxism. The most important thing to say about Lenin was how Lenin imagined the creation of a national cultural autonomy in the before the war, and then how he tried to realize this national autonomy after the foundation of the Soviet Union. We know Lenin died in 1924, but he had not too much time to elaborate his project. Anyway, we can say that Gramsci tried to take some of Leninian ideas from his project, but he also tried to change something for better, create a situation which was more similar to Italian history and I think also Jewish history. Well, Gramsci and the Jewish problem. Gramsci had a very important correspondence with his sister-in-law Tatiana from 1931 to 1932 when he was imprisoned by fascist Italy. Gramsci faced the Jewish question and Zionist fiercely during the First World War, but he demonstrated not to know very well the Jewish the problem, because Gramsci mostly had an assimilationist and illuminist position about the Jewish problem. Well, in his most important theoretical work, Quaderni dal carcere, there are some references to Zionism, racism, and antisemitism. And the most important is the point is the discussion on so-called parallel nationalization of Italian Jews. But Gramsci he thought that there was no need to explain why some part of working class had an anti-Semitic position, at least until the quarrel with Tatiana. This quarrel, the main question of the quarrel with Tatiana is Jews are mentioned or not mentioned men, did they belong to humankind or not? Yes, Gramsci was tried to defend the socialist position, saying that there is a difference, we know, between Eastern and Western Jewry, that Jewish imposed segregation was the cause of the failed assimilation. He also used the Marxian thesis of the spirit of Judaism as a spirit of capitalism. And at lastly, maybe the most important idea, Gramscian idea about the Jews, that is that the Jews, according to Gramsci, was a sort of diplomatic corps of international relations. But even if Gramscian position looks not so innovative, not so new about this problem, there is the recognition of cultural and national autonomy by Gramsci, which was, a semi-Bundist view of a Jewish national problem. But there are some open question in Gramscian view of national cultural autonomy, which are the position of Yiddish. Yiddish can play the role of a national language or not, and which is the role of the center of radiation, a spiritual center in this idea of Jewish identity, which can we try from Gramscian works. As we told before, Gramsci translated some part of Marx's Judenfrage, Jews' question, during his imprisonment problem, in order to support his asymmetric interpretation of socialism, and he tried to demonstrate the relation between Jewish and Christian religion in terms of alienation from nature. And the second point, most important according to me, is the problem of Soviet territorialization of Jewish communities during the 20s and 30s, and the sort of parallel nationalization which we have just spoken about in Italian case, which is the nexus, the links between language and hegemony in this case. And can we see that Yiddish could be turned in a socialized tongue? Yes, this is the problem. We know the Yiddish, the Soviet Yiddish, and the transformation in the 20s, etc., etc. The problem is, Gramsci knew Soviet experiment, something, yes, but Gramsci agreed with Leninian and Stalinian project of Jewish territorial autonomy. And what about the Palestinian solution, so-called Palestinian solution? Let me check now the problem of the state. The problem of the state was very important in Gramscian thought because Gramsci tried to understand why in Italy there was no mass movement for Risorgimento and why Risorgimento, Italian unification, was only an elite problem. Well, generally speaking, we can say four Jewish socialist position. Most important, we know personalist, populist, Tolstoyan, and Marxist. We know also that after the October Revolution, we have a big change in also in the Palestinian context, and we know the thesis of, for example, Sternel and the nationalization of working class in a Palestinian context. Well, but generally speaking, we know that Bund didn't formulate any position on the state because the most important problem of Bund was the problem of granting the civil rights to the Jews and not to create a different state in the diaspora, we know. In contrast, in Gramscian thought, we know that the state played a very important role because the state was not only expression of economic condition, actor of social change, but was also an instrument for educating the masses. And the problem, which is even if for Gramsci state, integral state, as he wrote in his writings, was very important for understanding the making of a new socialist society, which was the role of language and in this new state. That is, language was the key for creating a new state, for elevating the masses, or for what? These are open questions which Gramsci didn't succeed in answering because he died, we know, in 1937. We know that Gramsci has received a lot of interpretation in Italy, mostly in Italy, in the last part of the last century, and even if we can say that Gramsci had a political Leninian position, we can say that the Gramscian analysis of cultural phenomenon in Italy and had, can we say, a bottom-up effect. I will say also a Bogdanovian bottom-up effect, and this helped us to understand why Gramscian position can we consider it on one end a Leninian and from another end a position which can understand, I think, understand a territorial, also Zionist solution of Jewish question. From a general position, can we say also Gramsci had a position which was similar to Kautsky about the cultural autonomy of the Jews in the diaspora, but I think that the Kautskyan position or also Bundist position were not in Gramscian cultural model well fitted in order to grant to Jewish people a future in the diaspora, and therefore I think that Gramsci was very interested in elaborating the concept of center of radiation and also the concept of language and the role of the state in order to create a framework fitted for Jewish working class condition in the future of the diaspora. Thank you very much. I hope you.